walking to the Sugar Art Bar in Playa del Carmen. Sugar Art Bar and Grill, I need to say. We have a Bitcoin meetup there, a Bitcoin dinner. You know what it is, I think eating food and talking about Bitcoin, something like that. Let's see how big the crypto community is here in Playa del Carmen. Tulum, it's huge. In Playa, already here for a couple of weeks, we haven't seen one of the Bitcoin meetups yet. So exciting to see how big the Bitcoin meetup is and how many people are there and who is there. Always in for meeting new Bitcoin people, friends, you know. Bitcoin people, friends, what a stupid word. So let's see, guys, how this meetup is tonight. Thirty guys walking back home. It was a beautiful evening, good meetup. It took a little bit long, from I think 7 now to 11, so 4 hours. One speaker about tax. Yeah, not my thing, man. I would love to see speakers that tell you what to do with crypto and tax, and or not to do with crypto and tax. This one was more about traditional digital nomad people and how to handle their crypts as tax. But still, it was a nice evening. Let's see if the wife is still awake for some cushy cushy. Hopefully I'm lucky, guys. Hopefully I'm lucky. If not, see you again tomorrow. We just came from breakfast. It was a good breakfast.
Yes.
It was a healthy breakfast again. I had a not that healthy breakfast, but it was good. And when we were sitting there, I received a message on my Airbnb, because I requested a place here in Mexico as well. Yes, she's still searching also for Portugal, also for Mexico. So we are going to look at a house at 1 o'clock here in Mexico, in the region called Playa Carres, near the center. We haven't been there yet. So, but yes, we are also still looking into staying in Mexico for some time, because we saw a shitload of comments down below the video of yesterday. Never go to Europe, stay there, it's like crazy in Europe. So yeah, that made us decide maybe we need to stay some bit longer in Mexico instead of going home. You want to take a staircase? Why?
You need to pick something up.
What do I need to pick up?
A note.
A note, oh yeah, good. She's my agenda. She, yeah, somebody came to the reception. I was not here yesterday, I was to the meetup, and somebody called my wife from the reception. Is Didi there? I want to speak to him because I have a house maybe for him or something like that.
He could maybe help us find a place, or he just likes to meet up.
Okay, wait, I'm going to pick up the note. If you can film a little bit, then I will pick up the note. Hi.
They left a note for me.
Yes,
I have to. I don't know who, but
one of the owners here on the condo.
From here?
Yeah.
He's the owner here.
Yeah,
serious? It's not Jerry.
No.
Jerry.
I'm a Bitcoiner. I have been waiting. You're watching your channel for 4 years. I have a property in this one here. If I can help, I would love it to meet you. Cool.
You have this phone number.
That's cool. Thank you. Okay, that's strange. Serious?
Yeah, I don't know.
That's really strange.
You need to call him.
What?
Just call him.
Yeah, but be honest, this is strange. So
why?
We are searching for a house, and we are staying here, but the one we are staying in now, the lights, is going to, is booked. And now yesterday I went to the meetup, and this guy comes, I'm not going to say his name, and he's telling me, I'm following you already for 4 years, and in those 4 years, I love your videos, blah, blah, blah. I have a property in the place you're staying, and maybe we can make a deal. And he's a Bitcoiner, so I probably can pay with Bitcoin. That's cool. That's not cool. You know why? Look at her face. That face saying, I don't want this. This is not like a house. This is an apartment. I would love to go to a house.
You never listen.
Okay, then tell me one more time. Because indeed, I am a good listener, but I don't understand everything.
It is like an apartment and it has a kitchen, but it's really in a crowded place with a lot of noise. And it's like too many people here. Like holiday feeling vibe here.
Can you feel the difference between her and me? She hates too many people. I love too many people.
I get tired with too many people. I'm sorry.
She gets tired of all the people. I get the energy of the people. Do we have some more different? Why did we stay together again for 26 years? What was the? What is the? What's
because
the magic?
I am so easygoing.
Serious?
Yeah.
I'm not.
No.
Fuck. That's not honest. You know I'm very easygoing.
In some ways, but
you can only be. You know. To be very honest,
yeah,
if you're not easygoing like easygoing like me, you could never live with a very structured person like you. You need to be very easygoing.
No.
Yes.
No. I'm not that structured anymore, and I'm like really letting go of a lot of things. So no, I'm not. No.
So do I call him or do I don't call him?
Of course you call him.
Of course I call him. 303. Yes. I totally forgot to film. Did you like the house we just visited?
Yeah.
But? I hear in your voice there's a but.
Because it was pretty nice, but the rooms, yeah, it's not that nice. Too old.
Too old?
It's like in a horror movie.
Like a horror movie?
Yeah.
Like ghosts are coming out of the closet. Like that.
No, it.
Oh, it. Okay. Yeah. I completely forgot to film when we visited the house. So, I think it's not going to be the house. No? You didn't like it as well? I don't know if I'm filming you. No, I'm filming you for sure.
No.
No? Too old? Yes, I thought it was a horror house.
Not because it's old, but the garden, it was really small and no really sun for the pool and...
Nah?
Nah.
Okay. So, again, no beach day. I'm going to meet another guy that left the note this morning at the message, the message at the reception. So I'm going to go coffee. You want to join me? No? I need to go myself. I'm going by. Do I need to say yes to the house or just choose one? Or okay, so I'm going there now. The guy's name is Joe. Why are you nodding no? I saw you. I saw her. Now, I'm going to go to Joe and see if he has houses. Because he texted me he has, I think, 4 or 5 houses. So, or he has a shitload of bitcoins. Or he's just a middleman renting out the houses for other people that have a shitload of bitcoins. Let's see, let's figure it out. Guys, I arrived at this beautiful bar over here. It's called El Diaz, drinking a wine, a beautiful wine, together with a new friend. I met him here. I told you already before, we were talking about houses inside the common. Meet my new friend, Joe.
Joe Rangel. Hello, Bitcoiners. I am very, very happy to be here with Didi Dayudu. I finally get to meet this man that I have been watching for a very, very long time, who has been an influence in my life. And I thank him very much for this opportunity.
He's making me blush. I'm not going to have time to blush. Or it's the wine. It's our third glass. We are having a lot of fun. And we are not going to disturb this beautiful fun with this video. So that's all you get to see. But in the future, I may have a really cool surprise. We are working on something really special, but we'll go get back to that later, guys. Have a beautiful day. Ciao, ciao. I am finishing my wine. I just about to go. A guy talks to me. He is selling property for Bitcoin. I'm just going to show you what kind of property you could buy with Bitcoin here in Mexico. If the guy wants, I will put his details down below the video. Check this. You could buy this, guys. Wow, this is like... That's awesome. And we can pay with Bitcoin. And this is in Tulum, Aldeia Zama. It's like the one, the newest one they are going to build near the beach. All this you can own by just buying it with Bitcoin, guys. This is amazing. This is amazing. I'm starting to love Mexico more and more and more. I need to drink more tequila. Don't ask me how these cars still drive, but the most strange cars that we would go to garbage in the Europe, they still fix them here and they drive. But I just finished the conversation with Joe, an amazing guy. And he was the one that left the note at the reception. And from that note, I picked up and like, okay, let's meet the guy. Really cool guy, living here for 17 years, doing a lot of real estate. He's going to help me to find a house for the next month, maybe even some real estate. And when I finished the conversation with Joe, this guy is watching me and he's like, hey, can I speak to you? And I'm like, okay, of course, tell me. And he's like, Didi, I know you, you're the Bitcoin family. I do, but he doesn't speak really good English, a lot of Spanish. I'm selling a lot of real estate here. Maybe you should diversify Bitcoins. And I accept Bitcoin for all the real estate. He's selling more than 60 properties here and all like Bayergam and Tulum, and he is accepting Bitcoins. He showed me a few of them properties. They were like from 80K to $1 million, but they were all beautiful. So I'm going to talk with him again when I didn't drink 3 or 4 wines to have a chat about how to maybe, you know, introduce these real estate things to all the Bitcoiners that I know. And maybe I even buy one of these 80K apartments, you know, just to rent it out on Airbnb or other Bitcoiners that want to meet me here in Playa del Carmen, guys. All right, the music is a little bit loud. That was everything for today. It was again a very lively, beautiful day. A lot of things to do here in the Playa del Carmen. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did enjoy the video, give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and please leave a comment, as I love to respond to your comments. I'm going to zoom out now in Bitcoin. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more alive, have another couple of wines with my wife, some dinner tonight. Oh yeah, shit, I forgot. And we still need to focus. Are we going to go to Portugal? Or are we going to go stay in Mexico? If it's up to me, we probably stay here. But yeah, let's see where we will end up, guys. Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow again. Bam.